There are dozens of games to choose from and millions of chances to win. Some people play their luck every week, and some play every day.
Force a habit, hoping they would get the big one.
But who really does win? Well, just days before Christmas, Scott and Kathy Bennett of Hillsboro got lucky with a $2.1 million ticket in the Tri-State Megabucks. Stories like theirs are repeated often in the Granite State. In fact, people have won more than $60 million in New Hampshire over the past 2.5 years. According to state lottery documents that record every payout in excess of $600, there have been nearly 8,000 wins since July 1, 2010.
You gotta spend to win.
Jean Hammaker at Bunny's Superette in Manchester has sold her share of tickets, often to repeat buyers, which include high rollers.
Some are up to $300 a day.
But the norm is $100 or less. Now as for Jean, she sold a $200,000 winner once. And if you want to try out your luck, you may want to go see her too. That's because Bunny sells more winning tickets and pays out more cash than almost any other store in the state. 52 wins over $600 in 30 months, totaling more than $1 million.
We're just lucky.
Bunny's is only beat out by the Hannaford on John Devine Drive in Manchester by 3 wins, and they're followed by Amherst Mobile with 50 wins. Two other lucky spots, both paying out more than $1 million in total winnings, the Southbound Liquor Store in Hampton and Heath's Mobile in Portsmouth.
It's utterly and completely random on one level, and then it's based off of how much they sell.
So just who is it that is winning all these games?
They know me on a first-name basis up in Concord.
Sammy Dager of Manchester is one of the state's most frequent and biggest winners. 37 wins in 30 months, worth nearly $1.2 million. Almost all of his wins, ironically, are at Bunny's. Though his biggest, a $1 million scratch ticket, came from this Rite Aid in Manchester.
I had had the ticket for a couple hours before I scratched it. And it was a Friday night, and I came home, and I put it on my desk, and I ate dinner and watched the news, and then I got up to do some bills. And I scratched the ticket and instantly knew it was a $1 million winner.
That was a year ago, and Sammy says he picks up tickets almost every day, usually at Bunny's, and he usually has a win once or twice a month. So what's his strategy?
But I let the machine pick them for me. I don't try and outsmart the machine. The machine knows what numbers have come up frequently, what numbers haven't, and I figure if it hasn't come up for a while, it's probably due.
Sammy may be the picture of luck, but if there is a strategy to increasing your odds of winning, Lottery Commission Executive Director Charlie McIntyre says he hasn't seen it.
The tickets themselves are, the winning tickets are spread out throughout the entire print run. If there's 1 million tickets to be sold, the winning tickets are spread out equally amongst 1 million tickets to be sold.
And about those tickets, many people may believe that their best chances of winning big come from Powerball or Mega Millions. Powerball does lead the pack when it comes to total cash payouts, a whopping $4.6 million in prizes. Mega Millions also accounted for $3.6 million. But don't forget daily drawings or scratch tickets. $1 million cash spectacular paid out almost $4.2 million. Megabucks Plus racked up 529 wins, and the game with the most number of wins was Pick 4, 869 payouts totaling $4.6 million. In fact, Pick 4 accounts for most of Sammy's wins, which still don't seem real to him.
Oh, yes, I get surprised. It's right place at the right time.
Whether you try a new strategy now or keep your old habits.
Same numbers all the time. Looking at the tickets and just picking one you like.
I don't spend more than $5 a day, so it is what it is.
Hopefully, it's a win.
While a good portion of the Lottery Commission's earnings go to prizes, every single dollar of their profit goes to education. Last fiscal year, it amounted to $67 million. Reporting in the studio, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.